Now we will see the next topic, that is our ancient texts. Your texts in scriptures in the Harappan civilization or the Indus Valley civilization. First we will see about the Rig Veda. Now the Rig Veda, when we study about it, we will study some more things about it. That is, there are four Vedas in the Indian culture. First is Yajur Veda, Rig Veda, Samveda, and Atharva Veda. Yajur Veda, Rig Veda, Samveda, and Atharva Veda. Oldest one is the Rig Veda. Oldest Veda is the Rig Veda. It contains 1028 hymns, or it is known as suktas. The meaning of suktas is well-spoken hymns or songs. In other words, hymns means songs. Very well-spoken suktas are known as hymns. And it is written, in the old Sanskrit language or Vedic Sanskrit language. In the Rig Veda, you can find topics about the lives of the people regarding their political life, social life, economic life, and with the life of the Aryans. The first topic of history we have studied is about the Aryans, people living in the northwest part of India. And all these hymns or songs or suttas were written in dialogue form, that is conversation form. Then we will see some of the things or matters which are written in the Rig Veda. There are many things written in that. We saw 1028 suttas, but some of the features we will see. One of the things written in the Rig Veda is common man differences regarding the political life and social life of common man. There are examples given there in which the life of common man was divided into three types: Gan, Sabha, and Samiti. Gan is a small assembly in which matters were discussed, like nowadays in villages you have panchayats. The same is small assemblies where discussions were done regarding many matters. Sabha, a big large institution compared to Gan, but smaller than Samiti. It comes in the midst of both these. And in the Sabha, the head of the state or the main person leader used to give justice for all topics. If any problem occurred between two parties or two people, he used to give justice there. For example, you can consider him as a judge. And Samiti is the largest institution amongst all the three. Compared to these both, Samiti is the largest institution. It is an elaborate body, a large institution. And in that, the king was the head of the state. In the Samiti, the king was the head of the state. And to assist him or to help him, two persons were appointed. One is the army chief and one is the priest. These two help the king in his work, to conduct the work smoothly. And one more mention of the Rig Veda is that the Gaveshya, the Hindi word Gaveshya means war, or the main work done by the king was fighting wars to capture kingdoms. And example given was the battle of the 10 kings on the banks of the river Ravi is also mentioned in Rig Veda. As you know, in our society, still in the modern age also, we consider our family as the first member of society. Why? Because we start our life in the family. So for us, our family is very important. The same way for the Aryans, that is the people in those days, the main unit was family. For them, family was a very important institution of their life. And the system of family was patriarchal. Here the word students patriarchal means father, the male member is the main, important person in the family, the first member. If the father is not there, then the elder brother of the father. That is, in short, the male member is the main head of the family. Matriarchal means mother is the main head, or the female member. But here it's patriarchal means father is the main head of the family, or grandfather, who is the eldest. And joint family was also followed. Then, in those days, no racism or casteism was there. Race and caste were not considered. All were considered as equal in the society. And women held a very high status in society. They were considered on equal footing with men. And they were given much importance. They were considered as co-workers. Means, whatever work the males did, women could help them, join their work. And, especially, then women's presence was required in yagya. Students, the word yagya is offering sacrifices to gods. Yagya in Hindi is known as yagya. So during the yagya, during offering sacrifices to gods and goddesses, if a woman is not there in the family, it was not offered. So she was given much importance. And study was also given much importance for women. Women had to study much. And they were married off only after reaching the adult age, not before that. The examples given in the Rig Veda of women who reached higher positions were Apala, Lokamudra, Dosha, etc. They composed rituals in the Rig Veda means hymns and different verses they wrote in the Rig Veda. So in short, family was very important for them and women were given high importance in the family. Then there is mention of the names of different gods in the Rig Veda. Indra, Agni, Varun, Surya, the names of all these gods are mentioned in the Rig Veda. Then the name of other goddesses are Usha and Aditi. The meaning here is Usha stands for the morning goddess and Aditi stands for the evening goddess. All these names are mentioned in the Rig Veda. Then there is mention of something else like cows, horses and bulls were used by the people in those days for farming and for milk and milk products. So the Rig Veda mentions about these animals also. But in the Rig Veda, the maximum number of times the mention of the horse, the animal horse, is large. Why? Because horses were used for wars by kings. So the mention of horses in the maximum number of times. Then there is mention of pastoralism. The previous video we said about pastoralism, as told our students, pastoralism means cattle rearing in which cattle is taken for grass, that is for eating grass in the open fields and all in the meadows. So they rear for milk and for milk products. So pastoralism was also a sort of occupation in those days. And tribals fought for animals. People in the forest are these tribal people. They mostly fought for animals. Why? Because they wanted each other's animals. They want, like in the kings fought for states and areas. The same with tribals fought for animals of others. They wanted to take hold of others' animals, cattle. Then property was divided in family. It is on the basis of the number of cattle. The more you have the number of cattle, the more property you will get in the family share. And animal husbandry was done in a collective manner, was done collectively. All did animal husbandry. All animal husbandry means cattle rearing. Collectively they did it as a group. But agriculture was a secondary occupation. Why? Because they wanted cattle to be the maximum number instead of agriculture. Farming was secondary to them. All these things are mentioned in the Rig Veda. So students, here I conclude with the chapter. We did this chapter in three parts. We studied about the Harappan civilization, that is the industrial civilization, all the towns in that, and how they lived, the social, economic, religious, political life, everything. And our scriptures, the name of the lesson is Ancient Towns and Scripture. Scripture is the Rig Veda. The other three Vedas are Yajurveda, Samaveda, Athara Veda. These topics regarding the Rig Veda, what all is mentioned in the Rig Veda, some of the features we studied. The students read the lesson carefully and write down answers from the video file.